This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about solving exponential equations. So here's our first equation. This says 5 raised to the 3x minus 2 equals 28. Now the whole trick to solving equations like this is to take the logarithms of each side of the equation. So I'm going to take this and make it into the log of 5 to the 3x minus 2 equals the log of 28. Now I've got a rule that says when I take a log of a number that's raised to a power, I can take that power and make it the coefficient of the logarithm. So I'm going to take the 3x minus 2 and make that a coefficient. So I'll have 3x minus 2 times the log of 5 equals the log of 28. And now all I've got to do is isolate this x. So the first step is going to be to divide both sides by the log of 5. When I divide the left side by the log of 5, I get the log of 5 over the log of 5, which is just 1. So I can cancel those out. The right side is going to be the log of 28 over the log of 5. Now the left side is 3x minus 2. I want to add a 2 to both sides to get rid of those 2, to get rid of the 2. So I'm going to have 3x equals the log of 28 over the log of 5 plus 2. And now since I've got 3x, I want to divide both sides by 3. So I'm just going to have x equals the log of 28 over the log of 5 plus 2, that whole expression divided by 3. Now I know this seems complicated, but this expression is really going to be fairly easy to solve. We'll just use a calculator. So I'm going to have the log of 28 divided by the log of 5. Let's find out what that equals first. So that's approximately 2.07. Then we'll add the 2 to it. So I've got a plus 2 here. So that's going to be approximately 4.07. And then we'll take that and just divide it by 3. So that's 1.3568, and then it goes on and on. We'll just round that to 1.36. So we're going to have x equals approximately 1.36. So let me just review these steps. All I did was take the log of both sides of the equation. Then I was able to take the exponent that I had in this logarithm on the left and make that a coefficient. Then the only thing left to do was to isolate the x and use the calculator to find what this whole expression on the right side was equal to. And that gave us the approximate answer. Okay, let's try one more. This is basically the same thing, except I'm working with an e. Okay, so I've got e raised to the 2.3x equals 72. I want to take the logarithms of both sides. When I've got an e, usually the smart thing to do is take the natural log. So I'm going to have ln of e raised to the 2.3x equals ln, or natural log, of 72. I'm going to take this exponent, the 2.3x, and make that a coefficient. So I'll have 2.3x times ln of e, and that's going to equal ln of 72. Now remember, when you have the natural log of e, that equals 1. So I can take this ln of e and just cross it out. It's just a 1. Now I've got 2.3x equals the natural log of 72. So I'll just divide both sides by 2.3 to get an x all by itself. And I've got x equals the natural log of 72 over 2.3. So once again, we'll just use the calculator at this point. So I'm going to have ln of 72 Let's find out what that is. That's approximately 4.28. And we just want to divide that by 2.3. And that gives us 1.8594, and that keeps going. But we'll round that to 1.86. So x equals approximately 1.86. Okay, and this again was basically the same approach. We just took the log of both sides. Since I had a base e, I used the natural log. I took my exponent, made that into a coefficient, isolated the x, and solved the expression that the x was equal to. Okay? So take care. I'll see you next time.